He's super sweet.
Okay. Hello.
Jennifer,
Hi.
how are you?
I'm doing well. The convention's going to take a quick screen grab of us before we talk, okay?
Perfect.
Okay.
Smile. 3, 2, 1. Great.
All right. How
How
are you
you
going?
doing? Yeah, good. Hanging in there, trying to make the best of all this weirdness that's going on in the world, and enjoying some
Yeah.
time home and trying to be positive. How about you?
Not too bad. We've got our curfew now, so we between 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. we can't go outside and
Wow.
mask
Yeah,
and all that.
yeah.
I love the t-shirt that you've got.
Oh, my
The
vote
vote.
t-shirt? Yeah, thank you. It's company Madewell makes the makes these t-shirts. I thought it would be a good day to drum up some voting.
Why not?
Yeah, right.
Absolutely. Yeah. So yeah, I love the show Once Upon a Time, and
Nice.
House was also really awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, I wanted to know, like, with you're saying like that green screens are no longer going to be a thing or something, that it was like what LED
Oh yeah,
stages or
the LED
something.
stages. Yeah. So there's a really great example of it with the show The Mandalorian. I don't know if you have Disney Plus or not, but they have a it's called, I think, The Gallery of Mandalorian, which is like the making of, and it's like an 8-part series where they could get into the making of it. And you can see a great example of it where instead of having green screen, which is really tricky for directors because you're reflecting green off of everything, which means you're trying to avoid reflective surfaces all the time because you can't in
Yeah.
post replace every reflective surface. So it's just super limiting, And what happens is with the LED stages is they have like walls depending on how much of it that you need, but they cover like entire stages and ceilings with these screens, and they use video game engines to project the actual space. So someone goes out, a separate unit goes out and shoots these environments, like they shoot, the Grand Canyon or whatever, if you're,
Yeah.
whatever. And then you project it through a game engine, and it's running through a game engine at real time. And so you put your set and your stage and you build all the stuff, but what's around you and what you're looking at, the actors are looking at, looks like the Grand Canyon and feels like the Grand
Yeah.
Canyon because it's all being projected around you, almost like a virtual reality video game. And so as these screens get cheaper and as this technology becomes more and more accessible, and because of COVID and how hard it is to be filming in the world, I think more and more companies are really making this a thing. So what's going to happen is instead of having green screen where you're super limited, it's going to be more about building the libraries for these game engines to be able to project environments on LED screens.
Wow. It really is fascinating, kind of like where it's going. And I guess with actors, like how in like real life people stand further apart sort of anyway than how,
Yeah.
and
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if that affects the way people tell stories.
absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like, are you guys in kind of lockdown where you are, or?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much everything except for essential businesses are closed, and then there's like some restaurants if there's outdoor areas, and it's everything's just like spread apart quite a bit. So we don't have a curfew right now. We did for a long time. We don't right now.
Yeah.
It just kind of depends. Sorry, we're getting low on
Yeah.
time.
Oh, well, it's been
Yeah.
nice talking to you.
Yeah, it's been great talking to you too. I'm glad you're safe and healthy and hanging in there with all the quarantine, lockdown, all the stuff,
Yeah. If I was an American, I would vote there, but I can't.
I know, I appreciate that. I wish outsiders could vote.